This is James Cogan broadcasting to you live from Haifa. We just received a live report that 6 rockets have been fired from the south of Lebanon towards the north of Israel.
Haifa was under attack for 34 days. Haifa became a very attractive target for Hezbollah rockets.
Suddenly we heard a lot of explosions and we looked from the window, we saw a lot of missiles falling all over in the city and in the sea. We were not prepared that something will be so massive as it was. Immediately we had to get organized to a massive casualty event.
When we heard that a bomb fell in town, we knew that we were going to get people.
It's very important, first of all, to identify what kind of injuries there are. First are the injuries from the blast. Then we had a lot of shrapnel wounds. And as you know, these missiles contained a lot of stainless steel balls. These balls were acting as bullets.
We have to deal with very large numbers of people.
We make the classification between the ones that are heavily injured and the ones that can be in the sight of the slightly injured. And also the ones that are only psychologically injured.
העקרונות של טיפול בנפגעי חרדה בעקבות אירועים רב נפגעים זה להחזיר לבן אדם שליטה. קודם כל שליטה על גוף שלו, שליטה על עצמו, לעשות אוריינטציה איפה הוא נמצא. מה קרה לו, שאנחנו פה, שהוא במקום בטוח, לתת לו הרגשה של ביטחון. היה קשה לתת למטופלים תחושת הביטחון, כי גם אנחנו עצמנו בתור מטפלים לא הרגשנו מספיק בטוחים באותו רגע. כי מקום של אתר הוא לא היה מספיק בטוח מבחינת, לא יודעת, עקרונות בטיחות.
Whenever there was an alarm, we had a feeling that something can also happen to us.
We're not terribly well protected. Additional missiles are falling. Some may have fallen 100 meters away from us. We feel the vibrations. Some of the workers themselves are scared for their own well-being. We have learned to detach ourselves from other feelings which are very natural, very normal, and concentrate on the work.
מה שהיה חשוב, להוציא את החולים ולהגן על המטופלים.
So actually, when I heard the alarm, it meant call to action.
We are actually a beautiful hospital. We have, I think, the nicest view from here. But during the war, this was the most exposed hospital.
Certainly there's a problem about the safety of those people who are in the hospital. We shifted whole departments so as to move people from north-facing departments to the rear of the hospital so that nobody would get hit direct on should a missile hit. Top floors were evacuated and moved lower down. Every time there was an alarm would go, we shifted patients within wards. We would go to the safest part of the building, and when the all clear was sounded, we turning them back and forth.
We still have injured, mostly soldiers, in our rehabilitation department, which is the only rehabilitation ward in northern Israel.
And the third day that we got in into the Lebanon, Agshat.
חיילים שנפגעו הגיעו לשיקום למחלקה שלנו.
The guys were here, it's really warm and like a family here. They helped me to step on my feet again and walk.
הטיפול השיקומי היה מוצלח, גם מפני פיזי ונפשי, עקב הטיפול האינטנסיבי מאוד, עם כל האמפתיה כלפי הנפגעים במלחמה הזאת.
The staff of the hospital showed his beautiful face. Everybody came to the hospital, sometimes while taking a risk when the city was under a rain of rockets. Many of them have families and children in order to help them to be here. We opened a kindergarten. It was opened for 24 hours a day.
ההורים לא רצו להשאיר אותנו בבית לבד כדי שלא נפחד ולא נהיה בלחץ יותר מהנפילות והזקות. אז אבא שלי שהוא עובד פה, הוא הביא אותנו לפה. היה פה כיף ולא חשבנו ש... ולא הרגשנו כשאנחנו פה, שיש מלחמה.
During this war we accepted approximately 570 patients. I personally feel that we did a very good job, and I think this was also announced by the authorities. The medical assistance was very good, and I think we gave the best medical treatment.
My biggest concern was what will happen if, God forbid, the rocket will hit directly to the hospital. I knew that we have in the department facing the north, crowded with patients which we didn't find a protected area for them. In the very last day of the war, the rocket hit in the street beneath the hospital and caused huge damage.
To get ready. We cannot depend on luck. We know that the missile fell very near here. I think we have to do everything to be fortified when we treat the patients. It's, I think, unbearable. It's unbearable.
My duty is to do whatever I can to build protected area for at least 200-250 patients in the hospital. We located the places. One is the parking lot of the hospital. And the other part is the daycare hospital, which also located underground. I hope that we will be able to do it very soon, because the next war is only a question of time.